Today's show is sponsored by
818 Lounge in Montrose, California.
Hey, this is Diesel. Welcome to Nobody Cares Show. Before we get into the show, I've got a couple quick things to tell you. Don't get offended, baby. We're going to get racist and crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Not bad. What a James Brown concert.
Yep, no. It sounds like it. Nice. Godfather of Soul there in the background. Gotta love that.
Boom.
All right, well, check this out. Today's almost kind of like a homecoming for us because we kind of feel at home here now.
It's true.
Absolutely.
We're over here at the 818 Lounge. Nobody Cares Show is broadcasting live here tonight. We have a special event. It is a competition for basically, it's called what, the last performer standing?
Pretty much.
Basically, there's going to be 5 performers tonight. 2 will be selected to move on from tonight. Then next weekend, we'll be here again on Saturday the 27th. We'll have 5 more performers, and 2 will be selected from that night to move on. Then the finale will take place here September 3rd on Labor Day weekend, all blowout night, where the 4 chosen will go head-to-head for a cash prize.
Not bad.
Not bad, right, guys?
No way.
Well, before I go on, I want to introduce my crew here.
Yeah.
I got O-Squared running the boards.
What's up?
And, of course, as always, JJ Diesel's in the house.
What's going on?
And my name is Intelligent, and we are the Nobody Cares Show. Hoff couldn't be here tonight. We miss him.
Yes.
But he's holding things down in the Big V.
Big Vegas.
Not the vagina.
No.
The Vegas.
Probably
there, too.
Actually,
but
yes.
He's probably visiting the VJJ over there in Vegas.
That's a good point.
Yes. All right. Well, Nobody Cares, so what we do is we listen to independent artists' music, we critique it as the general public would, and then we have our own little rating system, and we rate the songs like this. It's either so horrible we're never going to listen to it again on purpose, 2, we would let it play on the radio without changing the station, after that we would download the song illegally, after that a very good rating would be to buy the song off of iTunes, and our best rating is buy the album, all right? Now, if you want to check out more about our show, make sure you go to our webpage, nobodycareshow.com, and you can submit your music there. Also, we have our own heat lines, Diesel.
909-907-HEAT, 909-907-4328.
And now we're receiving text on there, too, so you can leave a message or text us on the heat lines.
We've always received text on there.
Yeah, we already received.
Well, now we're advertising that we receive text.
We always have advertising.
Yeah.
Well, now we're doing it again because I want to.
Now you're just saying that.
Now you're just talking.
You're absolutely right because I love to talk. That's why I'm on a talk show.
That's a good.
All right.
It's not a repeat show.
Hey,
it's a talk show.
Hey. We also have an email you can hit us at.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's at nobodycareshow@gmail.com. Make sure you email us and we'll get back to you right away. Also, check us out on any of our sites. We're on Facebook, Twitter.
Blip.
YouTube,
Blip TV.
Subscribe, Blip TV, Bandcamp.
All of them.
Our SoundCloud.
Yeah.
Everywhere. Check us out there. Also, shouts out to our hostgator.com. If you need a website and you want to get a good one, go through them and use our promo code nobodycareshow.com and get a fat discount.
You don't gotta put .com. You can just put Nobody Cares Show and you'll be good.
No, actually, right. It's Nobody Cares Show.
Oh, I apologize. Nobody Cares Show.
For the promo code, it's Nobody Cares Show.
Yes. There it is.
Yeah.
Just Nobody Cares Show, get a fast discount.
Boom.
Yeah.
That's what it is. All right, I'm gonna turn time over to Diesel real quick. He's got some announcements.
Just real quick, a couple of our other, I'll say, family members, people that have been on the show. LOB, I wanna say best of luck going to Nigeria on tour.
Tight.
Very awesome. That's how you do it. And I want to say, Yoda, congratulations performing with the Juggalos.
Yeah.
I know.
Really?
You had a good show.
He performed with the Juggalos.
Nice.
That's how he does it. I don't know how. That's how he does it.
That's what I'm talking about. Shout out to L.O.B. and Yoda.
Boom. Yes. Doing things. Doing things, buddy.
All right. Good to see the family always involved in getting things done.
Yes.
So right about now, let's move on to a song.
Oh. All right. Shouts out to the 818 Lounge for having us.
Yes.
And let's get this
and
thing.
And Sean, especially Sean, the owner.
Especially Sean, the owner. Let's get this thing cracking. And first artist of the day goes by Maria Reyes. And she does symphonic melodic metal out of Australia.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Nice.
Maria Reyes is a soprano that not only does classical repertoire in her... this is a weird word. It's eras? Eras?
Let me see it.
Arias? I think she wrote it wrong.
No, it's classical.
Arias.
Arias.
It's a type of opera.
Yeah, that's
an aria.
I'm all like, oh, I know enough. and art and songs, but other genres.
It's Italian, dude.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh. Now taking her classical singing into another level through composition and performance in the symphonic and melodic metal genre. Maria,
this is going to be an interesting mix.
Maria is expanding her horizons with classical crossover through collaboration in other genres such as techno opera.
Wow.
All right, and this is Maria Reyes.
Wild.
With
Y. This could either be horribly great or horribly bad.
Oh, man.
Yeah. All right, this is Maria Reyes with Why Do This World Full of Stupid People? That was Maria Reyes, Why Do This World Full of Stupid People. And if you want to contact her, you can contact her at Maria Reyes, R-A-I-Z, 2003 at yahoo.com. You can also check her out on soundclick.com/Maria Reyes. She also is on studiotracks.com service, blaggity blaggity. That's, you should check out her site for this link. And she's also on myspace.com/Maria Reyes. All right, let's do it.
I guess I'll just go real quick because I thought that was weird as fuck. But you know what's weird? I don't know the most about all this kind of music, but it seemed like it fit it. It seemed like it fit her bio or the genre, rather.
Well, yeah, no, she described herself very well.
Yeah, and it's kind of, I was like, I'm hearing some weird, wacky shit, like from Silence of the Lambs 2 or something.
And you did.
And I did.
Oh, my gosh, I love this job.
There is a couple of things I think that I noticed. Honestly, like half of the music I like, half of it I didn't. And I mean, I think she has talent. I think she has a good voice. From what I could tell, this was honestly too weird of a song for me to like.
Right.
To be honest, this song was just way too weird for me to dig or like. And I've heard some stuff where I'm like, oh, that's kind of wild. I kind of like that. Well, this was one that I didn't really care for. You know, I really could never honestly like just picture myself being like, yeah, that's the business. Whatever. Well, I don't know.
Sometimes it happens that way.
But I'm gonna say Thank you for the weird submission. I've never heard of this kind of music before, so I appreciate that. That you opened my ears and my eyes to it. I love it.
Yeah. Wait, would you say it has originality?
Originality. This is full of originality. Originality. A little too much originality. Whatever happened to the good old days when music made sense?
I don't know.
So, I mean, you know what, though? I will give it to you for, doing your own thing and doing, you know. I will say that.
Yeah,
so, yeah, that's very cool. Yeah, and there's someone that may dig it, you know. So, thanks for the submission. That's pretty much where I am at.
All right. I thought the intro was a little weird. I'm not going to lie. Then, after a little bit, it just started, like, I got this little vibe of, like, old 60s, where there's an old 60s song where they were trying to do stuff like this, not even in metal, just...
Oh, just to be avant-garde?
To be avant-garde.
Yeah.
I got that feeling out of it, and then the metal came in, which the metal was just, it was just literally just blah to me. I actually wanted a little more out of the singer, like, throughout the whole song. It was just basically the whole beginning was just her, and then the rest was just, like, nothing. Of course, we didn't hear the second part of it, the ending, but I didn't expect too much different from the first part.
All right. Yeah. Fair enough. Intel.
Okay, I'm with you guys. It was a little different. Here's the thing. The thing that kind of disappointed me is she was talking about being an opera singer, so I was expecting a very classically trained voice.
Yeah, me too.
And I really didn't hear that. I heard someone who was trying to sing opera and didn't really have an opera-type voice.
Yeah.
So that was kind of disappointing. The mixture, though, you're right, did kind of work. It did kind of blend. Actually, my favorite part is when she stopped singing and I was just listening to the band.
Yeah.
I thought the band was pretty solid. I thought the lead guitarist was tearing it up at certain points.
My favorite part.
Yeah, but the background, what the rhythm guitar and the bass player was doing was so boring and so repetitive that at times I got lost.
Yeah,
and they said that it actually started to transition there at the end, and we had to cut it off. We really wanted to see where that was gonna go.
Yeah,
because it completely changed up.
It literally changed up.
Like it was a whole different song almost.
Yeah, yeah. Like it actually sounded like acoustic. All
yeah, like an acoustic guitar and everything. And she started singing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think my only beef with it really because she fit what she said she was gonna be. I just expected a stronger, more classically trained voice, I guess, from what she was saying. But other than that, it was just different. It was intriguing.
Yeah, I'll say that.
Intriguing.
What would you vote it as?
You know, I'm interested enough to listen to the rest of the song to see where it goes that I would download the song illegally.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm not curious. I'm not. And you know what, honestly?
Really, I couldn't tell.
It's obviously going to be for me, never listen to again, but I will say it wasn't that because you were awful, this just wasn't for me.
Yeah.
So, never listen to again, and oh.
I am kind of curious of where it's going to go.
For reals, right?
I really am, that's no lie, but.
But.
If this was on the radio, at the first beginning part of it, I would have changed it.
You wouldn't even given it that.
I wouldn't even have given it. I would have changed it right away. So, just based on that, I'm just gonna go. Just never listen to it again on purpose.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Well, your rating is gonna be never listen to it again on purpose. Hey, you know, maybe this style of music isn't for everybody, but I'm sure there's gonna be a following out there.
Yeah.
That, of people that are gonna love it. You know, it just didn't really speak to this group, I guess, at this time.
Yeah.
That's pretty much what it is.
Not bad.
But someone who always seems to get his message across into the hearts and minds of everybody is JJ Diesel, and it's time for his Jibba Jabba.
Yeah, Jabba.
Jibba Jabba in the 818 Lounge. Represent.
Oh, that was a good freestyle almost.
Oh, I wasn't trying to rap.
I don't try to rap either. I just do.
Yeah, that's why you're good at it.
Check it down.
That's why you're undefeated.
That's right. That's why I'm undefeated.
Freaking NCS shelter over here.
Boom. Very nice. Once again, I do want to say we are at the wonderful Late One Eight Lounge in Montrose, California.
Yes, we are.
Wonderful hosts, wonderful venue.
Great food.
Great food. I got to be honest, this isn't even just saying,
no.
Hey, great food,
no, great
prices.
Food,
we just ate,
yeah, we
some.
Just ate some.
And I got to be honest, I said, let me have some fries, right? I had some fries, and then I had, as you saw, the orange chicken quesadillas.
And how was that, Diesel?
I'm going to say this. Holy shit. Those were the business. I've never had such a combination of flavors in my mouth. You know what I'm saying? Got to be honest.
You had a lot of things in your mouth.
Oh.
You can say that again.
But I will say, great food, great price.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. And Intel, you had a little plate yourself.
Dude. Yeah, that was big, dude.
Dude, I had
she said.
It was a huge plate.
It was huge,
okay,
man.
And it was a combination plate. On this combination plate, I got chicken chow mein.
A load of it.
With steamed rice.
A load of it.
A fried shrimp.
Yeah.
And an egg roll. You know how much I paid for that? $8.50. Are you kidding me?
Wow.
And we're in an upscale spot.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna say, don't take our word for it. Take your own word for it.
That's right.
If you talk to yourself, I guess. Yeah, I don't even know what that means.
Take your own word.
Yeah.
Own
so eat it.
A little bit of in there.
So here's the thing. Eat it. Tell yourself in the mirror, and that's how you'll take your own word for it.
There it is.
And then another thing is that we also have a couple of things named after us down here at the wonderful 818 Lounge. Yes. We have hey, there's a black cowgirl. That's cool. A black girl with a pink cowboy hat came in.
Hey,
cowboy.
Hey, 818.
Maybe she wants to lassie you up and take you for a rodeo ride.
Oh,
rodeo.
Jump on it. Intel is your pony.
That's right.
That's sexy. So anyway, I'm going to say we have a couple drinks here that you can get. We have the Intel, which is actually a shock top.
Belgian wheat for only $5.
You can just say shock top.
Yeah.
That's good.
All right.
This guy's trying to be like, it's a Belgian wheat.
Well, because it's different shock tops.
Like, you know.
Yeah, but they all say Belgian wheat, though.
All right. I'll give you that.
So anyway, and then there's also a diesel that you can order for $5. It's a shot, and it's basically just, I think it's just really delicious.
Yeah, no, it's really good.
And it kind of tastes like a cloud.
Yeah. Like a cloud?
I'm imagining what one tastes like.
It tastes like a cloud?
A cloud?
Is that what JJ diesel tastes like?
Like,
what
so
mean?
You taste that cloud and then later you get some sticky
like
tears?
Yeah. The cloud gave me sticky tears. Fucking cloud. Fuck these clouds. They gave me fucking sticky tears. And there is also an O Square that you can order. And oddly enough, what's funny is his is a food one. Ours is drinks.
Right, right.
They're all, hey, tons of fun. Why don't we give you the food one?
Yeah.
Hey, no, but you know what?
I spotted that right
away. Hey, but his special is awesome for $5.
Yeah, it is.
It is garlic fries, right?
No. It's four garlic wings and a basket of fries for $5.
You're basically what it is. It's called O Square because it's square, like two appetizers.
Together.
For $5.
Dude, that's awesome.
Yeah,
that's
you
awesome.
Cannot beat that. So I do want to say that very cool. And I'm going to say, as you guys already know, I actually did get my wisdom teeth taken out, and it hurts a lot.
I was there.
Yes. You know, here's how you know when it hurts. The first few days, I forgot to,
wake up?
Nope. I forgot to show my man some love.
Because you were in such pain, you couldn't even think about
That's
it?
That's how you know when you're in pain.
Diesel, you should tell them how we got there in the first place.
How we got where?
How we got to the dentist's office?
Oh,
that we almost missed?
Yeah, he cut off a yellow jacket. But, like, he was in the left-hand turning lane, and he was supposed to go right. Actually, he honked, like, hey, can we get in? The guy looked behind us and said, oh, go suck my dick. Well, he didn't say that, but he seemed to say
it
that.
It sounded like that.
He seemed to say that.
His facial expression looked that way.
In your defense, it would have sounded like that.
Right.
Like, yes. Yeah. So he looked at us and just looked forward, but he had plenty of room to scoot up so we can get in his lane. Wouldn't do it. So Intel says, okay, how about this? On my green arrow light to go left, I cut across the whole world and go right. So that's what we did.
Did we not make it on time for your appointment?
Oh, it was very awesome. I'm going to say
that's how
this.
We do.
And then these meds. Here's the thing. These meds are giving me, I think, the shits and the bad, real bad gas.
Are you telling us that you took the lead with Bobby?
No, I've already had the lead, but no.
Yeah, oh, okay, yeah, okay, he still has the lead.
No, oh, I've had the lead. All right, but cool. Here's the thing. I was thinking about it. I'm like, wait a minute. I was like, I got a sore mouth and a sore butt. I feel like a gay porn star over here. You know what I mean?
I'm taking out wisdom teeth.
And then because of this stupid, my gas, we were actually talking to Sean, the owner of the 818 Lounge today.
Oh, man.
And it's on speakerphone, and me and O are right next to each other.
Yeah, we're having a meeting.
Yeah. So O's talking to him, and I just can't wait. I have to straight up, straight bust the super ass.
Bust the super far. And I'm all talking, and I'm all like, oh, I'm all like, you just do not just fart on the, we're in a meeting.
He was trying to not die laughing. That's I was awesome. Like, I had to, okay, first of all, I'm not a piece of meat. Rods, look the other way.
No, they were waving to the bartender.
Okay, tell yourself that, yeah, son. That. So anyway, I'm not sure if you heard, but I had to bust it up. And then
no, you didn't say that though. But the best thing's all right.
Oh,
all right. You do it one time, right? Just by accident. But this fool, later on, we're still talking, and this fool decided to do it again.
Hey, I blame the meds.
You know, we say we're at home, but dude, you're really not at home.
I blame the Vicodin.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna lie.
I would too.
And then I actually was a cool thing is I was sitting down. And to eat it, I was drinking a soda and I left it outside and I went inside real quick and I went back out.
Uh-huh.
And I was drinking my soda and I'm down at the end and there's something in my soda and I'm like, oh fucking shit. Dude, I go pour it out, there was a bee in there.
What?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I know.
How's that awesome?
It's honey flavored.
Yeah, I was like, I've never had honey flavored Pepsi before. So and then actually earlier I had a silverfish in my mouth. Because I drank and I was like, what is this? And I spit it out.
Dude, what is it with you and insects and drinks lately?
I got to quit leaving my drinks outside.
Yeah, you really do.
I have an issue with that.
Either that or you need to not drink the drinks that you leave outside after you leave them outside.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't leave drinks outside anymore, I think.
Right, yeah.
And then I'm going to say this. The little Deco, the baby, has a couple new trends. One of them is punching O in the balls.
Show him where the junk is, son.
Because I'm crazy today. Man.
Well, because what happened was I was telling O, I was like, dude, I'm all, he's starting to now, like, when he swings at you, he's closing his fist.
Hey, that little guy, he swings.
He's got a heavy hand.
Yeah,
he's got a heavy
hand. He packs a punch, yeah, Owl. Yeah.
So he decides to punch O. In his balls.
That's awesome.
Which I think is funny. I wish I could have seen. And then he actually, for the very first time, oh, look what we got here.
Nice. Socrates.
We got Socrates in the house.
Socrates.
Hey.
Socrates.
Fuck you then. No, I'm just kidding. Socrates is cool. Just kidding. That's the boy. No, I'm going to say this, though. For the first time, he saw Yo Gabba Gabba.
Oh, yeah.
And?
Yo Gabba Gabba is like crack. We gotta have got a boy Socrates on here. The wonderful, wonderful Socrates.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? Get up in there.
And Socrates, he just dapped us, man. He just gave us a couple of CDs.
Holy
right now.
Shit, are we lucky? His.
Yeah, that we get to listen to.
Yeah, you got the new album, Broke Ballin'.
Oh, that's okay. Oh, boom.
Boom.
And you got the old album, Knowledge, Power, and Money.
Oh.
Get up on that.
Cannot be mad at that at all.
Yeah, you got about 29 tracks of it.
Oh, nice.
Oh, my goodness.
So are you performing tonight, or are you just here as a...
Oh, I'm performing tonight. I'm getting down. Oh,
trying to get that money, right?
Trying to get that money.
Yeah, I need that cheese. Shout out to Doe, you know.
Yeah, so that's right.
So don't have to be broke balling, right?
Oh, shoot, I'm always going to be broke balling until I get that 25 mil.
Yes.
I need 25 mil to stop saying that I'm broke balling.
There that's it is, right, there it right. is.
Very nice.
At least you're honest about it.
Oh, yeah, real talk, real spirit with that one.
Very nice. Well, do you know when you're performing? Because I am very excited.
Either I'm going to be third or last.
Okay.
I'm saying last because that's what they say the best for usually.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Like the closer and shit.
You know, I like to shut it down.
And I do got to say, looking dapper as ever.
I make a good attempt at it. You know?
Look at, he's so.
So smooth with your hands. So smooth.
You, for some reason, you have the type of personality that I just want to keep fucking complimenting you because you're so nice.
He like personifies just smoothness. Just like comes in here just. real laid back, real low key, and then gets on the mic and kills it.
Yes.
Well, you know, I do me, you know what I mean? Just like I play the background, but you know, I take that attention.
I do like that.
That's right. All right, well, we're looking forward to hearing you tonight when you perform, dude.
Oh, for sure. I'm going to give it to you.
Oh, and one last thing. Tell everybody you can actually order a JJ Diesel drink. They go up and order the JJ Diesel. It's a little shot. It tastes delicious.
Get that JJ Diesel drink.
Believe it.
You know, man, it's going to have you feeling right.
Thank you.
All right, y'all. I'll holler at y'all in a minute.
For sure.
All right, man.
Very nice. Always good to see family. Socrates is the man. He always leaves us with some good stuff. So I know he's gonna shut it down later. So I'm not even worried about that.
What's going on, Creed?
Not even worried about that.
You gotta hop on our show later.
Yeah, we got
an interview.
Everybody coming through. That's how that goes.
Going on.
So it looks like Diana Ross.
Prognosis.
I love.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
So anyway, I'm gonna finish this up real quick. I gotta be honest, very awesome, very awesome. I was glad Socrates came out.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Very glad. Definitely. Yeah. But I'm gonna say this: Yo Gabba Gabba is crack for kids.
Oh, it is.
That's crack for
it
kids.
It is.
The baby went ape shit. I'm talking ape shit.
I believe it. It's the music that Aaron puts out, and then it's just Mossy's voice as the robot flex, and then Mossy in that outfit. Hey, just,
no, you know what it is, dude? Some of those songs I could write.
Yeah.
But the thing is, they're not even songs. It's like, here's the four steps to put away your toys. First, you open up the box. Then number two, you put your toys in the box. I'm like, that's just talking. That's not even a... What is going on?
That's the song. That's the whole song.
That's like a song.
You just copywritten a song right there.
So I'm like, I'm in the wrong business.
Definitely we are.
So I'm going to say...
I don't know if we can do a kids show. It might be a little bit too...
That's true. Yeah.
We can do a kids show for adults.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say thank you for listening. That's my time. And that's how that goes.
Thank you, JJ Diesel, for your jibber.
Yeah. Oh, damn. When they laugh, it's DC, and I'ma let you know. Hey, bounce. Get back to the script, I get back on my shit. No practice with this, I'ma score off the hits and throw it in the stands. Matter of chick, half an eight, I'm fucking with two dimes. Getting half an eight, he ain't fucking with six lines. Got these kids scared like pedophiles at release time. Neither it is or it isn't. These weak niggas call the game. The DC stay spit. Either it is or it isn't. All right, let's go ahead and get into another song, dude.
All right, next song of the day goes by the name Los V.I.P. And they do Latin fusion and reggaeton out of Cuba.
Out of Cuba? Hey,
Cuba.
Appreciate it, y'all.
Nice.
Shout out to the A1A
The reggaeton trio Los V.I.P. was created in early 2011 thanks to enthusiasm, friendship, and shared dreams among three natural gifted youth.
Hey, the people are excited for this song.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Together with excellent taste,
yes, sir.
The up-to-date urban sounds, Latin music, inspired and engaged from soul, the roots of the Cuban music. All right. And this is Los VIP with their song, Cuéntale.
Cuéntale. hago las cosas sin pensar. Pero disculpa, me la tengo que razonar. Tu mano me llega, yo vuelo por la cama expreso. Pero no me importa, no me quitaré por eso. A ver, so, chitenso, no solo con
All right, that's Los VIPs with Cuéntale, and if you want to contact them, you can contact them at galletacalypso@gmail.com, and if you also can find their stuff on cdbaby.com/cd/losvip, and you can also find them on their Bandcamp, losvip.bandcamp.com/album, Intención. Dash total. It'll be on our website, so go check it out.
Definitely.
All right, let's do it.
All right. Oh, go ahead. I want to ask, are we allowed to do our, should we do it in Spanish or should we do it all in English?
It's up to you.
Whatever you feel.
Most comfortable.
I haven't had one yet. I don't,
yeah, I guess. Sean's, sure. Sean's trying to provoke us into drinking.
Yeah, Sean's making us drink.
Yeah.
That's always a good thing.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
All right.
I don't drink it, dumb bastard. Shouts out to Sean.
Tonight you do.
It seems like it.
Shouts out to Sean.
Better be good. That's all I know.
Oh, believe me, if it's Sean, it's good.
It better be good.
What are we looking at? Oh, yeah, we're looking at the Elite. Oh, we're into that, dude.
I like
all
that.
All right.
He's showing us some liquors.
That's like top-notch vodka right there, dude.
Oh my goodness! Oh my. And Patron,
oh, Patron,
holy
the Patron,
moly,
the Patron, Ron.
Holy
the two
moly,
dumb bastards, Patron, Ron.
Patron, Ron. He's gonna have us take
he's
some shots with him.
Kill us right now.
He's going to murder us.
Yeah. Yes, he is. What is this?
What is that?
Oh, the Glen, the Glenlivet.
Oh,
I've heard of that.
I do like whiskey a lot.
Yeah. I think
it's like it's a Scotch whiskey or something they call it. It's like a Johnny Walker, but above it.
I think literally, right? Sean put us right here at this table just to get us drunk.
Oh my gosh, thinking. He's got some Glenlivet here.
You do.
Sean, he's showing us the 12-year. He's all not good. The 18-year.
Yeah. So the 18-year is the business.
Oh
yeah,
my
Sean,
goodness.
You know we have to do a show, Sean.
Oh my goodness.
We have to get a show.
Oh my goodness.
No. The Don Julio.
Oh, my
oh,
goodness.
Wow.
The Don Julio.
I think that might be the one.
I think that's going to be stronger than my Coke here. I think I'm going to be all right.
Yeah, let's do the Don Julio. What do you guys say?
Oh, wow. I've never.
Oh, my gosh, dude.
You're going to kill me. You're going to kill me.
All right.
All right. There it is.
I'm a little nervous.
It's perfect. We're taking a shot at Don Julio while we're. Critiquing a song from Cuba.
That is true. That is true. That
is appropriate.
No, you mean Cuba.
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 From Cuba.
De Cuba.
De Cuba.
Well, Intel, why don't you let us know what you think about it?
Okay, Los VIP. Mira, a mí me gustó mucho la canción. Les voy a decir la verdad. Usualmente yo no soy un fan de reggaeton, pero
however,
me gustó que tenía mucho. Digamos que no solo
chill?
Fue reggaetón, si
oh,
yo
no.
Pude escuchar mucho influencia de salsa también en tu música. Me gustó mucho el cantante, cantó súper, súper bien. Sus armonías y todo fueron perfectos. Mezclaron muy bien con la música. Y después cuando el rapero entró, yo me sentí que lo hizo súper bien, que... dijo todo con el ritmo, con mucho, digamos que fue muy suave la manera en lo cual lo hizo. Y sobre todo me gustó la canción. Y usualmente yo no, a mí no me gusta el reggaetón, pero fue bueno.
Oh my goodness.
Nice.
Yes,
please.
In
English, I was just saying that, dude, I really liked the song. I thought it was awesome. I love the fact that it had a lot of influence of salsa in it, not just reggaeton. The singer himself was awesome on the track, and when the rapper came in, it was very smooth. And I usually don't like reggaeton, but I did like that song a lot.
Then I'm going to say, before I get my Don Julio on, I'm going to say I agree. I love the music. I loved his voice. I didn't care what he said. I didn't know what he said.
Dude, the singer was bomb. Like his
harmonies? I'm gonna say this. I love this song.
Yeah.
I thought this song was awesome. And even we even had a couple of bystanders put the cans on and just
they started
grooving. So I will say I felt their energy.
Definitely. And they felt the energy.
I loved it. So that's where I'm at. I loved it. Oh, why don't you let us know where you're at?
I don't like reggaeton. I actually hate reggaeton.
I'm the same way, but I love this song.
But not this one.
But this one had.
You know what? We need to take a little quick drink break because we got a wonderful host here.
Salud.
Salud.
Boom.
Salud. Here we go. Let's do this. That was so smooth.
Yeah, it was smooth.
You know what?
You did not feel that going down at all. It's going to hit you later.
Hell yeah.
Well, what's so weird is because I don't usually take shots, and
that was good, man.
That was very smooth. Yeah.
That is a premium tequila, my friend.
Wow.
You're not going to get many tequilas like that. That's not cheap.
I don't drink tequila.
That's not cheap.
I don't drink tequila, and I drink that.
Yeah.
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 So
very smooth.
Oh, Sean, I was saying I don't take shots usually, you know? No, that's why I was afraid of it.
I don't even drink.
And that was delicious. That was delicious. Holy moly. I'm going to say this. Holy moly. Oh, my goodness. Oh, that was delicious. Goodness. I can't believe I was able to take that. I didn't even punk out. I thought I was going to punk out.
So did I.
Because of cheese.
I took a sip and I was, whoa.
Yeah.
This is going to be like cheese.
Oh, yes.
But then taking the shot was good.
Then again, we got to trust Sean. He knows what's good.
Definitely.
He knows what's good.
He's all about class.
Believe that. That's why we're on the show. That's why he's got us here doing the show.
That's right.
You thought not?
No right. doubt. Sorry, O.
No, that's good. It was Sean's fault. I blame Sean for giving us the shot.
Yes, we're going to blame Sean for this one.
No, but overall, actually, I'll dedicate that shot also to Los VIP because I don't really like reggaeton. And this one, I wouldn't even consider reggaeton because
it was more like a salsa song with like a reggaeton beat,
yeah,
right?
Because yeah, I love the beat. I love the fact that you brought the Cuban feel to it.
Oh, yes. Definitely.
Yes. I loved it. It wasn't like even reggaeton. I know you can hear the influences of reggaeton, but it was completely different with the Cuban beat to it. Oh, man, it was just a great fusion. Yeah, great fusion. I agree with everything you said in Spanish. I'm not going to repeat it just for our fans because they probably don't know.
Right.
But I pretty much agree with them. Whatever he said in Spanish, that's the fact, Jack.
That is true.
I truly enjoyed it to no end. That's what I got.
Very nice. So, look at Sean is trying to get us bent. Sean is trying to get us bent.
I don't blame him.
I'm gonna say
that's a good host.
I'm gonna say this. For me and O, two things we don't like: reggaeton and tequila. Right now, we had a delicious reggaeton and a delicious tequila.
Yeah,
there it is. Delicious reggaeton. Yes.
So, what's your vote?
My vote is I'm going to buy it. Screw it. I'm going to buy it.
Well, that's weird because I'm also screwing it and I'm also buying it. I don't have anything this great like this.
I need more music like this in my life. I am buying this album.
Boom.
Nice.
So right about now, you guys just received the highest rating that we have on the show. And when we have that happen, we do a little something like this. Let them know, O.
Oh, man. Even better than you.
Congratulations to you guys. This is the first ever best around at the 818 Lounge.
Yes, that is true. That's
so definitely
fact,
a first.
Unanimous.
Definitely a
unanimous.
First. So congratulations to you guys. Felicitaciones.
Felicitaciones.
Lograron nuestro premio
más alto que tenemos.
Más alto que tenemos, ¿cierto?
Yes, más alto que tenemos.
Entonces,
porque te decimos ve Abraham porque tono si cuenta, ¿sí o no?
Muchas gracias por tu canción.
Yes,
thank you so much for submitting. This was really, really, really awesome.
Yes.
All right.
Very nice.
Oh, let's get into another song, dude. I'm feeling good tonight.
Yeah. Looking
maybe
good.
Maybe the tequila, but I'm feeling good.
true.
All right, next artist of the day goes by One Glimpse Away, ironically. And they do alternative rock, alternative metal out of, help me out with this city.
Yekaterinburg. Yeah, Yekaterinburg, Russia.
And they're out of Russia.
I mean, Yekaterinburg.
Yekaterinburg, Russia. One Glimpse Away is a power trio whose music could be described as alternative grunge rock, but One Glimpse Away's music could really be better described as combining the melodic sensibilities of bands such as Alice in Chains or Incubus with the grungy tones and vocals of bands like Nirvana, Stain, and Deftones.
What?
This fusion creates a sound that's new yet still familiar and comfortable for the first time listener.
It's like it sounds like you're trying to talk someone into anal sex. Don't worry. It's gonna be comfortable.
You're gonna love it. I'll just be gentle.
It's gonna be that same same comfort of the vaginal entry, except for it's just gonna be in your butt. You're not even gonna know I'm in there. Hey, it's ribbed for your pleasure. What are you complaining about?
All right, and this is One Glimpse Away with their song Alive. That was One Glimpse Away with their song Alive. And if you want to contact them, you can contact them at TommyLinthurst@gmail.com. And you can also check them out on their website, OneGlimpseAway.com. All right, let's do it.
Do we have a guest? We
have a guest in the house who's going to critique this song with us because he listens to most of it.
Oh,
Prognosis,
nice.
Mr. Frankie Zales himself is in the building.
Yes.
Have a seat here, buddy.
Good, man. How's it going?
Yo, what's up? Man, how you guys doing?
Perfect.
That's perfect. Yeah. That's what we've done.
One of the headphones covering one ear and the other one off. So I don't want to disrespect the performer right now.
Yeah.
Just go ahead so you can enjoy the rest of the
But yeah, that track right there, you want me to critique that, huh? you know what? I don't normally listen to that genre of music, but
very
it sounded
nice
to me like he was on point for that genre.
Genre,
like some real of what he does.
Not too bad.
There you go.
If I did listen,
that's to that where music, that used to be our. You guys created a fan. That's very good.
Maybe I might start.
Very nice. Very nice. That is tough.
You know?
Oh, what do you got?
You don't know about me?
Love music.
The same OG?
Yeah. Actually, I kind of feel the same way as Prognosis. It was really good. I thought the production was great. I thought they played well together. I thought the mix was great. Everything, the whole sound was great. Me personally, I wasn't too keen on the vocals. Not the vocals, just his voice. I wasn't too keen on it.
Okay.
It threw me off a little bit. No, let's go ahead. That's what we do.
Oh, you know what? Sorry to interrupt, but honestly, that's one point. That's a good point. Usually, that's the first thing I look for is dope lyrics.
Well, you know what? With this, you don't. It's not. Well, what we've talked about is what's good. Well, I guess what's different is that you don't always have to have. What's weird is you don't always have to be, I guess, the most audible when it's a rock song, as opposed to being an MC.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when you're an MC, you always want to be audible. There's no way around it. But in here, some people care if they understand it. Some people don't.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like you got a good vibe though.
Yeah.
So that matters a lot, especially with this, you know, with rock and alternative rock and that kind of stuff. So
yeah,
both of you guys actually make sense. You know what I'm saying? What both of you guys are saying. What else you got?
That was my only beef, was I personally wasn't too keen on his voice.
You know what? I personally, I thought the intro was very cool.
Intro was very cool.
I actually liked his voice. Oh. You know what was very true?
It was One Glimpse Away. That's the band name.
And the song was Alive.
Yeah, the song was Alive.
Mm-hmm. I will say this: the chorus was very tricky.
Yes,
because it looked like it was about to come up, and it didn't come into anything that I thought it was going to come into.
Yeah.
I felt like it was going to come out like bang, and it just maybe it's because it tricked me. It kind of made me upset that I got tricked.
Yeah.
The hook was a little, I don't know. I think it was okay, but honestly, as the song went on, I got kind of lost with it because I've heard lots of different screaming and lots of different.
Yeah.
I just felt like this song really could get lost for me. You know what I mean? Could kind of get lost in a lot of other songs, and it didn't really blow me away, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I think it was done well.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it was done
But there's
very
lots
well.
Of songs done well that I don't listen to, and I think this is one that I don't know. I don't hate it, but it's not something I really would look for, to be honest with you, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much where I'm at. Intel?
All right. This is the way I felt about the song. I thought the instrumentation was great. I loved the sound of the song. But my beef with it was the lead singer's voice when he was singing regular just didn't really appeal to me.
Yeah.
It was funny, though, because when he started screaming, though, and getting, like, really into it,
I enjoyed it more, yeah.
Like, I could feel his passion, I could feel his emotion, and I actually, which would usually be the opposite for me. But in this case, I really liked that part of it, and I thought he was more into it than when he was singing. When he was singing regular, his voice just seemed kind of mediocre to me, like it wasn't really that impressive. But I thought the band themselves had a pretty solid sound, and I liked the feel of this song quite a bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, the thing about it is what's weird is it did sound, I didn't mind his vocal tone, but I get what you're saying. But I think what's weird is that he did seem like a better screamer than singer.
He really did.
You know? Which is okay. I mean, he was pretty audible. I thought he did okay.
Yeah,
I thought he did really well. So, what would you vote it as, Intel?
Honestly, let's see. I'll download this illegally.
I'm gonna let you know real quick what our rating is. It's never listened to again. You would let it play on the radio. You would illegally download it. Or steal it. You would buy the single from iTunes, chip them off a little bit because they're that good, or you'd buy the whole album.
Yeah.
What do you think you would do off of this just little bit that you heard?
My situation is a little different.
Yeah, no, but but this stuff, the one you just listened to.
For this song, what would you do for this song?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, but for this song.
And I just think my stuff is worth.
Yeah.
Diamond record plus. this guy
there
right
there. There it is. Fair enough. Well, I'm going to go next because that's what I'm going to vote it as. Play on the radio.
Nice. Production level is really high, and I'm really keen on production level. I'll break them off chips. I'll break them off a little chips, and I'll buy the single.
Nice. Very nice. Yeah. Very nice.
All right. Well, what was your vote? Oh, I'm sorry about that.
iTunes.
I guess it's going to make it download illegally.
Yep.
I think that's what it balances out to.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Very good rating. Congratulations. Thank you for submitting to the show. And yes, it's okay, though.
It's
no,
okay.
You and
that's
I did.
Your opinion. That's
you
your
and
opinion.
I did.
He had the same
oh, yeah, he did, too.
No.
That's your opinion.
This show deals with honesty.
What's the next step up?
This show deals with honesty, but the final rating is download illegally, and we're grateful
about that. Downloaded.
It's still a good,
thank you for Sales Prognosis for sitting in with us on that song.
Yes,
thank you very much.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Very
and
nice.
We hope you have a great night.
Yes, yes,
and,
yes.
Right about now, we're going to pause for a second for our hosts. Here's the thing, dude. If you want to break into the industry, you're going to need your own webpage. To get your own webpage, you're going to have a host. Why not use HostGator.com? We do. They're pretty cheap. They have great deals, and their service is incredible. Plus, if you use our promo code NobodyCaresShow,
you're a moron.
Sorry, NobodyCaresShow.
That's better.
You're going to save even more money. So why not use HostGator.com?
Hey, this is the D's from the Nobody Cares Show. When I'm not hosting the greatest show on earth, I like to cool out and kick the actual factual at the 818 Lounge with my partners. Centered in beautiful Montrose, California, or Glendale for you less sophisticated, is a place where you can do it all. Whether you feel like hanging out at the bar, macking in the lounge, ordering some delicious food, or even going upstairs to play a little pool. Yes, there is an upstairs area, and yes, it does have a bar. Both bars fully functional with all the best spirits for all the best prices. And if you're lucky, you might even catch performances by the newest, hottest up-and-coming acts. Most nights are no cover charge and locals always get in free. So join the D's at the 818 Lounge in Montrose, California. Tell Sean the owner I said what's up.
All right, you know, do we have a minute? Oh, we have an artist here. It was the first artist of tonight, DC.
Yeah, go ahead. Go
who
ahead.
Would love to come on the show and be interviewed real quick.
Boom, yeah, let's do it.
All right.
Let's
do it. Let's hop on. Let's see. This is DC, right?
Yeah,
let
yeah.
Let the people
DC.
Know who you are a little
what's
bit.
What's up, y'all? Yeah, my name is DC. I represent Pasadena, California. 210 West. Me and my boy Symptom. Shout out to the 210 West movement. Pasadena, California. How we do it? Shout out to my people's Provocative Entertainment. They in the house right now. Nice. Meet Bullies.
Oh,
my boy
you, Cree. You're cool with Cree, huh?
Yeah.
That's one of my people.
I'm cool with Cree. Me and Cree. Grew up together.
Nice.
Yeah, that's my
man,
brother right
we
there.
We heard you doing your thing up there on stage, and you were killing it. This fool took a J-track and said he kills J-tracks like Siegel did, and I just about fell out my seat.
Yeah. Yeah, because, man, you know, when I that's going to be on the mixtape, by the way. The mixtape is called No Features.
What?
And it's just me all the way through.
What?
I got
when is
a couple
out?
Bonus tracks on there. It's I'm gonna try to get it out by the end of this month.
And where
you know
can you
mean?
Get it?
So look out for that. I'm gonna have it up on iTunes, Amazon, everything by then. So just keep looking out. You can hit my Reverb Nation page, reverbnation.com/preacherskid. Hit me on Twitter at DC the Genius, just like it said in the sounds, THE Genius. You hit me there.
Very
all my
nervous.
Music is available. You know what I mean. And I'm just trying to get out there, get my name out there. I appreciate you guys doing
hey,
this
we,
and let me come
on
here.
We appreciate good music,
you know,
great
speak
artists.
My piece.
Well, we heard, man. You were doing your thing up there.
Thing,
I was
yeah.
really
yeah.
impressed. I was really impressed.
Well, I
yes,
will say
yes,
this.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
As soon as I see you go up, I was like, I'm gonna leave.
No,
I'm just
no,
kidding.
No.
I was actually gonna take off real quick to go. Go smoke a square real fast and make a quick call. And I heard you. I was like, and he see me.
Yeah.
I turned around and walked up and hung out for a little longer.
You flipped the bitch and came right back.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I'm going to say,
that's what's
I don't got to lie to you and say it was hot. It was hot. It was good.
Yeah, it was good.
Definitely.
Yeah. Very nice.
Yeah, no, we're definitely
going to
shout
it,
out
thank
when
you.
That mixtape drops. So let us know and we'll get that promoted for you, dude.
Yes. Take a card. Take
definitely,
a card. You got
it.
Take a card so
thank
you can submit to the show.
Yeah. Put on blast.
Yes.
Oh, man.
You can submit a song
so got,
to our show and we'll get it for you on the show.
Yeah. For real.
Definitely.
Oh, let's do it. Man. Right. Shout out to the Nobody Cares Show.
Nice.
Y'all know what time
thank
it
you,
is.
No problem.
I appreciate it, man. Thank you,
man. Thanks for the time.
Thanks for the time.
Thanks for the good music. good luck with the
for
the tournament.
Time.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
good
and one last thing.
Sure.
I'm trying to get the most drinks. Tell everybody to order the JJ Diesel drink.
Yeah.
It's a shot.
So what's
it's
that?
Shot.
What's in that?
And I guess it's supposed to taste like.
Okay.
Or you can have a man so you can order the Intel, and that's a shock top for $5. You know, so.
Wait, what makes mine not a man's drink, man? What the fuck?
Little sweet shot.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, no, you don't want. Oh, just because you didn't come with the lady. Oh. All the. You know what I'm saying? The ladies you came with. Get them a
Get them a D. Down to the brass tacks.
Screw the drink, man. If you're hungry, go get the O Square. That's good food.
Okay.
French fries. They double it up for you just like the O Square does.
Only
French
problem
fries
is
some weight.
Looking like O Square.
Okay.
That is true. But
hold on, fat.
You can see
minus
me.
The gray hair.
You can see me. That shit's good. That shit's good, man. I'm
yeah.
not lying.
I'm going to check it out. One more time, man. Shout out to the Nobody Cares Show, man.
Yeah,
ReverbNation.com/PreachersKid at DC
yeah,
the Genius on Twitter. Holla at me, man.
Very
thank
nice.
You,
very nice. Right,
I appreciate
you,
it.
For sure, man.
Thank you.
Very nice.
Cool people, man. Cool people.
Well, you know, I'm telling you, I love when people come on and they're good artists. Like,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
That makes your life easy.
And it makes our job so much easier.
It does.
Definitely.
It does.
All right, we got another song.
Yes, we do. We got a returning artist from show number 73, and he got a radio. And if you want to hear a sample, here it goes.
You see that I shine, yeah. I shine so bright. I don't know wrong, I know right. My flow's so mean, it's not polite. Say I'm great, I'm like I know right. But everybody not getting me. Say that I...
That's right. How it goes, cuz Intel is white. But that's all good, cuz it is all right. I want a beer, but not a Bud Light. What the fuck?
I had a combination plate with rice.
Yeah, and guess what, baby? It was out of sight.
By the Intel at a very good price.
That was heat. All right, this is goes by the artist Young Rob, and he does hip-hop out of Westland, Michigan. I am a young artist. My career started in Michigan. I was born in Philly, PA, but it wasn't until 2006 when I started rapping. One of my friends told me to take it further, so I did. Shout out to Young Deuce, and this is his song, Can't Believe It, and this is Young Rob.
Shawty, you need a plan. Just leave your man. I can be your man. Now understand that man ain't nothing. Talking like he big, but he just bluffing. He ain't got nothing. He just fronting. I'm a real dude. I'll show you something. Show you something that you're gonna like. Unbuckle my pants. They too tight. Girl so fine every time she in sight. Got me wondering what I'm gonna do tonight. Baby, we fly. We about to take flight. Without your clothes on. That would be right.
Oh, I can't believe it. Ooh, ooh, she out on me, me. I think she want me, nah, I can't leave her lonely. No, ooh, I can't believe it. Ooh, ooh, she out on me, me. I think she want me, nah, I can't leave her lonely. No.
Can't believe it, she's so cool. She the type of girl that makes all the boys drool. I'm not lying, she know what I do. I keep her wet like the swimming pool. You could be in my bed, you could be giving head. You heard what I said, putting hickeys on your neck. Now watch how I put your man in check. Tell him he weak, he can bring what's next. It don't matter, I'ma call or text you. By the end of the night, you could be my boo. It's not a lie, best believe that's true. I didn't lose.
choose my girl, that's you. I told you to understand, she don't like you, she wants another man. And I'm so sorry that you had to see, and just to let you know, the other man was me.
Alright, that was Young Rob with Can't Believe It. And if you want to contact him, you can contact him at youngrob215@yahoo.com. You can do a search for him, because that's all he gave us the info. I don't know if he has a website or nothing like that. All right, let's do it.
All right. Who wants to go on this?
Dude, let me go.
Go.
Okay. That was Young Ross, right?
Young Rob.
Young like Rob. All right, dude.
Like in Robert.
Here's the thing.
Now there's a shock top.
Oh, there goes an Intel right there.
I mean, an Intel.
Nice.
Someone bought an Intel.
That's right. I'm up. I think I'm up one.
Well, you're going to win because everyone's going to buy that ahead of
us. Yeah, for real.
That's true. I picked the most popular drink. I'm sorry. Yeah. All right, here we go.
I'm going to pick a water next time.
There you go.
I'm going to
go. There you go.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. So here's my thing, dude. You were okay. Your flow was on point. I liked your delivery. You sounded good on the track. Lyrically, you were fine. Nothing too spectacular, but I enjoyed listening to it. I wasn't bored. But if you're going to do a mixtape song, choose something where we get to hear you and not T-Pain throughout half of the song.
That is true.
Yeah.
Like, that kind of pissed me off because I want to hear the artist. I don't want to hear T-Pain again. I've already heard T-Pain on
this
track.
That's the easy way out.
Yeah. Basically, like, almost 30 to 40 seconds of the entire song was listening to T-Pain.
Yeah.
We're not here to listen to him. We want to hear you. We've heard T-Pain on this track.
You've heard him before?
Yeah. He's great. He did really well on the song. I think he went number one at one point, didn't he?
There's a chance this song might have been heard a few times.
Yeah, just a couple. But overall, dude, like, as far as your skills go, you're cool. Like, your swag's on point. Like I said, the lyric was fine with the beat. And I like the playfulness in your voice. It was, you brought out a character in you, which was cool.
Yeah.
But I just wish I could have heard more of you so I could have critiqued you more. I was kind of disappointed that I didn't get to. That's where I'm at.
All right. I'll say good choice. I did like the track, though. It was a good choice in track. Good choice in letting T-Pain do your work for you.
There you go.
You know what? To me, the vocal track sounded a little off from the rest of the music to me.
I kind of agree.
And I was like,
I don't know by like how you mean, like.
But it sounded like it was away from it, different, like kind of separate from it.
Okay. Yeah.
You know what I mean? It didn't sound like it was solidly mixed down to one nice track.
Yeah. That's what I was saying.
I will say. You did. I like this better than your last song, I think, a little bit. My vote's not
a lot better. His delivery's improved so much, but
my vote's not going to reflect that. Yeah. So,
and the great thing too is before his punchlines were very deliberate and very predictable. Yes. This time, not so much.
This time, not so much.
Here's the issue. You're comparing this with Crap, which was his last song.
Yeah. Right.
You're not comparing
so
this to. Listen. Yeah, but at the end of the day, it's still not that great of a song to me.
Yeah.
Just because it's better than your last song doesn't mean it's a great song.
That is
true.
That's what I'm saying. For me, I'm not as big on it as you guys are. Yeah, it's better than the last one, but it's still not a song that I really like. Oh, you know, I think you did better. That's good that you improved. Your voice is cool. I honestly thought your lyrics were okay. I thought some of them were good and some of them were not that good. Mm-hmm. So that's why.
Yeah, that's true.
When he said I wasn't bored, I was kind of like, well, there were some parts where I wasn't bored. I was like, okay, cool. But I just thought it was.
But how did T-Pain do?
What about it?
How did T-Pain do? Was he any good on the song?
He's alright.
Yeah, but don't you want to kill? Well, to me, wouldn't you want to murder?
Yeah, that's true.
Come on.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? So that means that he should have really blown this up because this was his opportunity to show somebody up then.
Yeah,
exactly.
And I just, like, I feel like it was okay. I didn't hate it. But I didn't really, you know, I didn't really love it. But, you know, you did make improvements, like they said, and that's a very cool thing. So that's good to see and hope you keep growing.
I got that you did step up your game lyrically from the first one. The first one, you were predictable from your first song.
The first one, you were fucking shitty. That was an awful song,
yeah,
dude.
It kind of was.
This is the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame compared to the last one. Yes.
And that's what we're coming with. So lyrically, you came and you weren't super wild with it, but you just keep doing yourself, and you know, like you improve, and you just keep practicing, and you're gonna get better at it, because I saw the style that you're going for, like a kind of like a Lil Wayne style going.
Yeah.
But you're not gonna top Lil Wayne.
No.
And I hate Lil Wayne. I don't like the way he raps. I just don't like his voice, all that stuff.
Yeah, but, I'm with you on that.
Yeah, but literally, you're getting better, and that's what we want to see. I want to see improvement from the last time. I also wrote down that Intel said that what did you say about his flow? That he was on point?
He was very on point. He was very.
I didn't think so.
You didn't think he was with the beat?
I honestly felt like he was like almost reading it, and it felt like he was trying to rap.
I'm with you on that.
Instead of just feeling it and just letting it flow by itself.
Okay.
That's what I came about it. I mean, it was way better than the first one.
Fair enough.
That's what I would improve. Just try to be free. It felt like, you know what it felt like? Like me trying to rap. Like I would do it.
So
like
for a would you rapper, and you've had some pretty good lines as well.
Yeah, well, I can write.
Yeah.
I can write. I can't rap.
But like you're concentrating so hard,
I concentrate on like I'm trying to get what I wrote down because I know what I write. It's tight.
Yeah. Maybe you just sound great because Joe used to come after you and little Joe was garbage.
Well, that was the purpose of me having him to go first.
Smart, very smart.
I'm smart. And that's what I got. Overall, the track, I agree. Little Pain took most of the time. I would like to hear you more, and you actually got better. We could probably give you a little more. Even if you don't be afraid to just do stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Just put yourself out there because we'll critique you, and you're just going to get better. If we say anything bad, you're just going to get better, and that's where you want to go. You just want to get better. You know, that's what I'm doing.
All right, what would you vote it as?
You know what? It's better than the last one. The last one got radio.
I already knew it.
I'm going radio.
Oh, you surprised me. You're smart. That's what I'm going.
Yeah.
Nice setup.
Yeah, that's what I'm going.
Let's see. When T-Pain and Wayne did it, I think I illegally downloaded it, and that's where I'm at again.
Oh, nice.
There you go.
So your rating, though, is going to be radio. If it was on the radio, it wouldn't change the station. I can't help but think that if we would have heard more of you, that might have changed.
Yeah, it probably would have.
I think so. I really do.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for listening to the show. We hope you enjoyed the show today over here at the 818 Lounge in Montrose, California.
Boom.
We had a great time here, and we're glad that you guys got to meet a couple of the people that were involved in the competition tonight.
Absolutely.
You know, great surprise there. And please, if you like the show and you want to find out anything else about the artists that were on the show or anybody that we even interviewed on the show, check us out at nobodycareshow.com. We'll have all their contact information posted up, and we'll listen to their music. Also, if you want to be an artist on the show, I'm sorry, go ahead and click our banner at the top of the page and submit your music. Check us out at all our different sites. We're at youtube.com/nobodycareshow, Twitter, Facebook, Blip TV, Bandcamp, RStage, SoundCloud. Check us out all over the place. Please like us, subscribe where you can. If you want to get these episodes onto your MP3 players, go to itunesstore.com and also go to Zoom Marketplace. And if you go to iTunes, please subscribe. That way you get all the episodes.
You get them all. Free.
But just subscribe at YouTube and you get them all anyway. So
subscribe on all of them.
Yeah. Free.
Exactly.
All of them free.
Shouts out again to our host, hostgator.com. And shouts out to 818 Lounge and Sean for having us here tonight. We've had a great time.
Great time. We hope you guys had a great time with us. Absolutely.
Exactly. And I think that's it.
Yeah, all right.
That's pretty much it. Any shout out?
Shout out to L.O.B. Yoda.
Didn't we have a best around?
Oh, you're right.
Yes, we did. Oh, my goodness. Someone's falling off over there. Quick, while he's doing that, shout out to D.C. who interviewed on the show and for Prognosis for doing a critique on one of the songs.
Very cool.
Frankie Zales.
Yeah,
shout out to Canvas G for helping with the event.
Socrates.
And Socrates for coming through and saying hi.
Our best around song gets played out at towards the end. Thank you, D.C., for reminding me.
No doubt. Those VIPs with
Cuéntale.
Very nice.
We're going to give shouts out to Hop. Shouts out to Big Hop.
Shouts out to Hop. Have fun in Vegas.
Have fun in Vegas, dog.
Boom.
Shouts out to Hollywood. Dan the man. Get that thing done, son.
Boom.
We're coming to you. We're coming to you. BBJ. Shouts out to BBJ. Shouts out to Coco. People, just keep it hot.
This music makes me want to get up and dance, dude.
For real, man, it's so good.
I'm feeling that. Like, I just want to find like a fly little Latina girl and just get the business going on the dance floor.
There's a couple around here. Go get them.
I'm just not. The one with the white dress is especially fine.
Hey,
get them all.
I've been noticing upstairs since we popped. Ladies are upstairs. Ladies are upstairs.
What's going on?
Yeah, ladies are upstairs today.
You guys are gonna have to.
Shouts out the chemistry.
Yeah.
Shouts out to partners again.
Yeah.
Shouts out to DC.
Shouts out to Elsa. Thank you for delivering us here.
Elsa, great food. Thank you for delivering it.
Shouts out to the bartenders.
Bartender for hooking up the drinks tonight, and for Sean for covering the tab.
Yes.
Thank you, Sean.
We got great hosts here.
Great hosts.
Oh, and before I forget, shouts out to Justin Credible, who's here tonight also.
For real. Yeah, that's true. Shouts out to him. Shouts out to the 818 Lounge. What's the address?
4710 North Verdugo Road in Montrose, California, 90210.
Oh,
right. Check out Low VIP. They're on CD Baby, so that means they're on iTunes. They're on Amazon.
That's right.
Go get their album.
All the way from Cuba.
From Cuba.
Los Estados Unidos.
Cuba.
My name is Tony Montana, and I approve this message.
Cuba.
Nobody cares, so don't fuck no shit from nobody.
True.
First you get the money, then you get the power.
Then you get the pussy.
That's right.
Yeah.
Me, I like to go out of order and get the pussy first.
Yeah.
The money and the power hasn't come yet.
And you gotta be bro balling sometimes.
I gotta have one of them.
Bro balling, like Socrates said.
Like a boy Socrates said it.
Yeah.
Boom.
I love this. This is salsa right here, dude. This is totally like salsa right here.
Yeah,
this
it's not even reggaeton.
It's delicious.
Subscribe to JK Diesel on YouTube.
Check out the Smoke and Ice interview.
Check out Smoke and Ice.
Definitely.
Just you know what? No, the thing is, instead of telling them individually, the thing is, they can subscribe with one click to everything.
That is true.
Just subscribe to everything you got on there, because we got a whole bunch of stuff going on, and it's all good behind the scenes stuff, interviews, and me.
Yeah,
that's a pretty good
thing.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, thank you very much. We are out.
Peace.